A circular lamina. Oh, here first we'll go for grid mode, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. So command is limits. So here by default lower left corner is 0, 0, upper right corner 297, 210. Then zoom all. Now we'll go for a line command. Consider any point and click on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse to the right side and click on first button of the mouse again and take the cursor to the top side and again click on the first button of the mouse and then enter. Then go to offset and take the distance as 297 and select this vertical line and offset to the left side and again go to the offset, take the distance as 210, select this line, horizontal line, and offset to the top side. Then go to zoom, extends, and zoom 0.6x. Then go to fillet between this line and this line, similarly between these two lines and similarly between these two lines. Then go to zoom window and select this and go to dtext, specify start point of text and take the height as 4, rotation angle as 0 and type 131 problem. Here a circular lamina of 50 mm side, 50 mm diameter, rests on HP such that one of its diameter is inclined at 30 degree to VP and 45 degree to HP. Draw its top and front view. Draw its top and front views in this position. So this is the problem which is given to you. So now we need to solve this problem. So here first we go for zoom window and now we go for layer, click on the new layer and say XY and enter, click on new layer, type locus, click on new layer, type views, and then go to layer 0, set the line weight of layer 0 as 0.05 and say OK, set the layer line weight of XY layer as 0.13 and say OK, set the layer of set the line weight of locus as 0.05 and say OK, and set the line weight of views layer as 0.5. Then go to line type of locus, then click on this, click on load, type the cursor here, type D and say OK, and say dash dot and say OK. So then you close this. Now we go for circle command, draw a circle of diameter 50. So type this, then go to line, quadrant of this and quadrant of this. Now we go for array, select objects, select this, then go to polar, take the center point of array as this, then go to rotation angle, associate angle between, so select edit array as base items angle, so number of items is 12 and say exit. Then go to, so then you just click on this, go to CH and go to layer, make this layer as views and say escape. Then you switch on the line weight. Then go to line, draw a horizontal line and go to line, take intersection point of this and take perpendicular to this. Then go to line, take intersection point of this and take perpendicular to this. Then go to line, take intersection point of this and perpendicular to this. Similarly line, take int of this and say perpendicular to this. Then go to fillet between this line and this line. Now fillet between this line and this line. Now go to break, select this, fit F point at the rate, again break first point int at the rate. then go to select this, then layer, take this as a views, and then go to mirror, mirror this entire thing and along with this, and take nearest point on this, mirror with reference to this line. So now we have this, go to explode, explode this, then go to erase, erase these lines from here. Then go to this. So this is how you'll be able to get the initial position. Then go to copy, select this entire thing, copy to the next location, and then go to rotate, rotate this with respect to endpoint of this. So the rotation angle is 45 degrees, type 45. Then go to line, take endpoint of this and draw a horizontal vertical line. Similarly, line, take endpoint of this, then go to line, quadrant of this, and draw a perpendicular to this, and go to fillet between these two. The next line is, go to line, take intersection point of this, and draw a horizontal line. Again, take intersection of these two, then go to line, take endpoint of next here. Similarly, endpoint of this line, and then go to trim between these two lines. Trim this as the cutting edge, and also this as the cutting edge. Take these two and trim this line, and here trim it. Similarly here, then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line. Similarly, int of this and draw a horizontal line. Then go to line, take endpoint of this. Similarly, take endpoint of this. Then here, go to trim, take these two as the cutting edges, and take trim on this and also on this. Then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line. Similarly, intersection of this and draw a horizontal line. And then go to endpoint of this and draw a vertical line, and take trim on this line and also on this line. Trim it this here. Now once you do that, then go to ellipse command. Take the center point, you take int of this, specify other endpoint of the axis, you take intersection point of this, and take int of this. Go to ellipse, take center, or take specify axis endpoint of ellipse, you take intersection of this, and intersection of this, and take intersection of this line. Then you just go to this line, and go to layer, and change it to views. Now we need to split this. So go to break this vertical line, first point int of this, and say at the rate. Similarly, f break first point int of this and say at the rate. Similarly, break first point int of this and say at the rate. Break first point int of this and say at the rate. So break first point int of this and say at the rate. Now we have done all the vertical lines. Now we take horizontal lines. Break first point, you take intersection of this and say int. Similarly, break first point, take int of this and take at the rate. Break first point int this and say at the rate. Break first point int of this and say at the rate. Break first point int of this and say at the rate. Now we want to group them, so go to group, select group, select objects, you select this entire thing and group them as a single one. Then go to zoom, previous, and go to line, take intersection point of this and draw a horizontal line here, and again take line, int of this, and then draw a horizontal line. And go to line, take nearest point on this at the rate 200 less than minus 30. So then go to DDIM, minutes, make it second decimal point. Then go to text, take it as text height as 4, align with the dimension line, centered above, take this dimension as 3, symbols and arrows, arrow size as 4, and lines offset from the origin as 3. Say OK, then close. Go to dim horizontal, take intersection of these two, and this dimension is 50. Then go to dim horizontal, take intersection of these two, then you are going to get 35.36. And then go to circle, take nearest point on this, take the radius as 50, and then draw a horizontal line as the locust line. Then go to break, select this arc till here, and you select this arc till here, then erase it. Then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, go to circle, take center point of this, and take the radius as 35.36, and then go to break, select this, and break this till here. And from here, you break this on this side. Then go to, now we go for erase of these two. Then go to copy, select this entire thing, take intersection point of this, and take center of this. Then again, zoom, then go to rotate, select this, base point, intersection of this, and then reference angle, take it as 0, new angle, take intersection point of this. So this is how you will be able to rotate this. Once you do that, now we go for breaking of this, and then you select this, break this line, the locust line, and select this line, go to layer and make this as locus, and type this as 5 and say escape. Now we go for the projection of this. So this point is this, so go to line, take intersection point of this and draw perpendicular to this. Then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line, that point is intersection of this, and then perpendicular to this, go to fillet between these two. Then here go to line, take int of this, so these two points are from here, go to line, int of this and say perpendicular to this. Similarly, line int of this and take perpendicular to this, then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, line int of this from here, so these two points are from here. Now int of this perpendicular to this, similarly line intersection of these two, take perpendicular to these two, then go to fillet between these two. Then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line. Those two points are here. Line int of this, take perpendicular to this. Similarly, line intersection of this and take perpendicular to this. Then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, line intersection of this and draw a horizontal line and take intersection of this and perpendicular to this. And line intersection of this and take perpendicular to this, then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, line intersection of this and draw a horizontal line and take line intersection of this and perpendicular to this, and then go to line, take intersection point of this and take perpendicular to this line, then go to fillet between these two. Now go to line, you say intersection of this, int of this, int of this, and then go to int of this, int of this line, then go to int of this, similarly int of this, then int of this, then go to int of this, then intersection of this, and type int of this and intersection of this, and say close. Then go to pedit, select this, and go to join, select this entire thing, then fit it. Then you go to fit curve, then go to pedit and take fit curve, so it will going to fit the curve to this. Then select this line, then select this curve, go to layer, click on views. So this is how you will be able to get the drawing. Then go to break, select this, this line. Now you go to see layer and make this as XY. Then we go for DDIM, then go to modify, take the primary unit as zero precision and say OK and say close. Then go to dim horizontal, take intersection of this and int of this, and here take the text, type %C 50 mm, so you are going to get the diameter symbol. Then go to dim angular, select between this line and this line, so here it is 45 degrees, dim TED, so text ID dimension and place it near to this. Then dim angular, select between this line and this line, so you take 30 degrees here. Then again dim angular, select between this line and this line, so here text, give space and enter, and you bring it here. Then go to zoom window, select this and go to m text, select this window, then go to symbol and type b, and enter. Then go to move, switch off the ortho mode, take it and place it wherever you want. Then go to zoom previous, then go to d text, so here put up the caps lock xvp and then hp and then y here. Then here you mark this point as a, you mark this point as d g and h. Then similarly, sorry, k, then here a dash, here it is d dash, here it is g dash, here it is k dash. Then press enter, then go to zoom window, then go to move, select this x, you take vp, you take hp, you take a, then d, then k, then g. Similarly, you take a dash, you take d dash, and you take k dash, and you take g dash. Then go to copy, select a dash and copy it here, and select d dash and copy it here, and select g dash and copy it here, and k dash and you copy it here. Similarly, you take a and copy this here, and that a should go here. Similarly, d, copy this here and that d should be here. Similarly, g, copy this here and that g will come here. And similarly, k, that k has to be here and also here. Then go to d dash, d text, so here you mark this as a dash, you mark this as d dash, you mark this as g dash, and you mark this as k dash. Then go to move, select this and you mark this as a dash, and you keep this d dash, keep this as g dash, and you keep this as k dash. Once you get this, then go to zoom previous, then go to move, select this y and move it nearer. So this is how you will be able to create the drawing. Then go to save, go to appropriate drive, go to CAD, lamina drawing, and here you type P131 and say save, and finally you exit the drawing.